An open book exam is an assessment method that allows students to refer to class notes, lectures, or any textbooks while answering the exam questions. In this take-home open book exam, you will be provided with the exam questions that need to be answered and submitted online on the test platform within 48 hours. Open book exams require students to answer in more critical, analytical, and innovative ways. It's important to know that the exam will be easy. We actually decided to use this method in our course because we believe it is the easiest method available for you in this stage. At the same time, you should not assume that you will be able to find all answers directly in the lecture or the textbook. You will clearly find the answers when you understand the entire topic and are able to summarize it and link ideas together. The questions in the open book exams measure the interpretation and application of knowledge, comprehension skills, and critical thinking skills, rather than recalling the knowledge or locating the answer in the book or the lecture and rewriting it in the answer sheet. I will now discuss the most important types of open book questions and examples. The first type is understanding questions. It's used to measure your understanding by building a specific meaning from the information provided to you. For example, we ask you to explain how something happened, or to give an example, or what does this mean, or what is your understanding of something. The second type is application questions. This type includes the application of knowledge or understanding on a specific task or a real problem. For example, we ask you what procedures would you take if you are asked to establish a specific fruit farm. Or there are symptoms of a specific problem in the field. What causes it and how can you address it? The next type of open book questions are analysis questions. These questions measure the different concepts and how to distinguish between them. For example, we ask you to compare this to that, or what is the relationship between this and that. The fourth type is evaluation questions. This type measures your judgment on concepts or ideas. For example, we ask you what is the best way to do something, or what is the most important or most effective way to do something. The last type of questions is innovative questions. It measures your ability to develop new ideas from the information you know or understand. For example, we ask you how you can design something, or what alternatives are available for something, or what can happen if something happened, or what solutions do you suggest based on your study to solve a specific problem. Well, how do we evaluate your answer? The total score for this theoretical test will be 70, with a passing score of 35 or more. And if the score is less than 35, the student will fail. And you should know that the exam results will be announced as pass or fail only, and there will be no grades. The table in this slide contains the criteria that we agreed to use to assess the answers to all the test questions. It is graded from failure to an excellent scale for three evaluation elements, including The first evaluation component is whether the student has answered all the test questions. We agreed that the maximum score for this component is 10 out of 70. So we recommend that you organize the time available to you well and try to answer all questions regardless of whether your answer is right or wrong. The second evaluation component is whether your answer is accurate, simple, and comprehensive. This component contains most of the test points, which are 40 marks out of 70. We recommend that you read the questions well several times and use your time wisely to think about your answer and arrange your thoughts so that the most important ideas are expressed first in your answer and summarize your answer in an appropriate way. The third and final component of the assessment is the extent of your innovation or creativity in formulating the answer. And this component has 20 marks out of 70. The most important thing in this component is to formulate your answer with your own words and understanding, linking information in the literature and lectures together, but not only transferring the answer from the literature and put it as it is in the answer sheet, or to copy and paste the answer from a colleague. I must confirm here that if we find two or more identical answers, these answers will be considered cheating case and will be cancelled from the test, and these students will fail to pass the test. Let me make this very clear to you. Simply, if you answer all the questions and rely on yourself only to answer these questions, you will pass the test very easily. As for the exam that begins on Thursday, June 18th at 10 in the morning, I will post to you an announcement before 10 a.m. on this platform, Microsoft Teams, that shows you the link that you should follow from a computer or mobile phone. If you try to enter the test from the link before 10 a.m., you will find that the test link does not open. The test platform is automatically programmed to open from 10 o'clock, and the test platform will remain open to download the theoretical exam paper, and after that to upload your answer and the other information required for only 48 hours. And after that, the platform will automatically close on Saturday, June 20 at 10 a.m. and you will not be able to submit any files after that. For this, you must adhere well to the examination time and instructions, and you must finish uploading your answer on time before the end of the test duration to ensure that no unexpected problems occur at the last minute. Well, when you click on the link displayed by the red arrow, you will enter the following test platform. This is the first page that will appear to you in the test. It is a link to download the theoretical test file for this course. When you click on the link indicated by the red arrow, the exam file will be downloaded. Download this file and leave the test platform for the time being, and don't click next. We will go back here and continue the next step when you are ready to upload the test answer and other required information. This is the format of the test sheet that you will download and contains all required instructions. It will be in PDF format. Of course, we are not writing questions at the moment. When opened, save it to your computer or mobile phone, and it can be printed if you prefer. Start reading all questions slowly, several times. Then organize your time to answer the questions. As for the answer, you can write it on your computer using the Microsoft Word, and then you save it in the form of a PDF file. Or you can write it in an organized way by handwriting on a plain paper, and then you can scan it or photograph it on your mobile phone and save it as a PDF file. And don't forget to write all your data at the beginning of the answer sheet, which is your full name, your national ID number, and the test seed number if you know it, and your section number, and name this PDF answer file with your full name. It is also required to scan or photograph your national ID card from both sides and save it as a PDF file, and this file name is your national ID number. For non-Egyptian students, use your passport. The size of each test answer and the national ID card PDF file must be no more than 100 megabytes. It is actually more than enough for you. If the file size is larger than that, the platform will not accept the upload. You should train yourself in how to make such files before the exam. Well, when you are ready to upload the answer file and the national ID file, you will enter the test link again from the Microsoft Teams course platform. But this time, you will click on the next icon shown in the red arrow. This page will appear to upload your answer to the platform. You are simply asked to take 5 simple steps illustrated by the red arrows. Note that any field marked with a nearby red star, this means that it is a mandatory field that you must fulfill in order to complete uploading your files. For each step, there is instructions. Note below as a reminder of the basic requirements. The first field, which is a mandatory field for writing your full name, as it is written on the national identity card or passport for non-Egyptians. The second field is also mandatory, which is uploading your national identity file. Click on the upload file icon to upload the national ID file from your computer or mobile phone from the place where you save it, according to the instructions. Note, if you violate the instructions and try to upload any file other than PDF format, or if the file size is greater than 100 megabytes, the platform will not accept the file uploads and you will not be able to complete submitting your answer. The third field is also mandatory. It is to upload your answer file. Click on the upload file icon to upload the test answer file from your computer or mobile phone from the place you keep it, according to the previous instructions. Note that the platform accepts only one file upload and one time upload, whether in the case of a national ID card file or an exam answer file. The fourth step is optional. Click to create a check mark in the box next to send me an email receipt of my responses. So the platform will send you an email confirming that you submitted your information on the platform. When you complete the previous 4 steps, click the submit icon, which means uploading all your data, which is the 5th and the final step you will take. As you can see on the slide, the student's name has been written and the national identity file has been uploaded, but the student committed an error in uploading the answer file or forgot the answer file and pressed the submit icon, and therefore An error message appeared explaining the missing point in red. In this case, you upload the file again. When you upload the file correctly, its name will appear in the location of the upload file icon. This slide shows you the final view of the answer upload page when the required steps have been implemented correctly. Number one, write your full name. Number two, upload the national identity card file. Number three, upload the test answer file. Number four, click on the send email box. And number five, the last thing you do is click the submit icon. This will send your data correctly and you will see the following message. The message shown by the red arrow is the last thing that will appear to you after your answer is sent correctly. An important note is that the platform accepts uploading the answer only once for the student's university email, which means that if you uploaded your answer and want to modify something, you can't. So don't rush to submit your answer. You have 2 days. There is a lot of time available for you. Also, don't delay uploading your answer at the last moment. I advise you to upload it to the platform several hours before the end of the test duration. An unexpected problem may occur on your computer or mobile phone, or the internet may be interrupted for any reason, and therefore you will not be able to upload your answer on time, and the result will be that you will fail the test. The last thing I would like to emphasize is that all academic teaching staff in this course are ready to help you and answer any questions you may have until the exam date or even during the test. That's all. I wish you the best of luck.